Howdy, I am Cabe Lindsay. This is my son Daniel, Gabriel, and Rosalie. Today is July 24th, 2017, and we are here to talk about art. First of all, Rosalie, I'd like you to tell us about this piece of art right here.
I made this one for Nana. I drew a bunch of colors. It is a rainbow, and I really love about it.
It's a beautiful rainbow that you made for your grandma, right?
I want to do one.
So pretty.
Can I do one?
All right.
Can I do one?
Now, Daniel, what can you tell us about this one?
I made this for my daddy.
It's really special to me. Gabriel, you want to tell us about this one?
I made this. I drew this.
No, daddy drew it.
Did you draw that one or did dad draw it?
I drew it.
Oh. Well, what I see in this one is a man flying, and he's actually not having to fly, though, because his brothers here are holding him up. This kind of reminds me of acro yoga, how we, with our bodies, become ladders and shields to help people do really special things. This picture represents clairaudience, kind of another type of superpower that we see is real in an actual life for some people. It's a beautiful thing for a human being to be able to communicate with an animal or a plant and gain value from each other's relationship in that way. These are glimpses into a future world where the imagination is open, the creativity is flowing, and new abilities are available to human beings. So these are just a few examples of the way art and imagination helps to create a better world for us. Here's a quick note about my background. I hold a Master of Arts degree, and I'm a published author with a couple of books. This one has a really cool section about future art and the importance of it and the value of it. I consider myself an art enthusiast and a passionate artist who works every day to bring more beauty and color and mystic energy into the world. I'm also a filmmaker. This is the documentary I created with my wife. It's called Wild Family. And it's not so much about us, but we are figures in the story because we had a hard time with parenting at one point, and we started to imagine and work to create a better world for our family. And we did that by interviewing 40 different families on the subject of parenting and family life. And we had a lot of breakthroughs in our life as parents and human beings, and especially as artists.
I'm too tired to do this, Daddy.
So, in summary, I just want to say that art is who I am, and artist is the way that the Creator made me. I don't really have any other choice. I've tried to pursue careers in other areas and study other areas, but I always come back to the art as my main way of contributing to society and providing an income for my family. I can't express enough the value and the importance of art for my own personal life, and I'm just one human being. I bet if you interviewed any of these kids, they would tell you just how important art is to them too. I see them using their imaginations, creating new worlds with their Legos, creating awesome artworks with their colored pencils, with their markers. They sing and they make music and they write songs. I'm so impressed with these kids, and my dream is for all kids everywhere to embrace the God-given talent for art that they naturally have. That's my dream. Does anybody else have anything they want to add to that?
I want to be a bakery like Jeff when I get a bachi.
That's another art form right there. It's called culinary arts.
Actually, I want to be a yak so when I grow up.
You want to be a rock star when
I'm
you grow up?
I need all of those things when I grow up.
Well, I see that we all value the art in us, and I think we can thank God for allowing us to be artists and giving us certain talents, and giving us tools, and tools like paintbrushes, tools like imaginations, to be able to create art and bring more color, more beauty, more flowers, more rainbows into the world.